Welcome back to EarthBound. I'm in front of the library. Unfortunately, the library really isn't that important. There's really nothing going on here. This is basically your tutorial. You know, how to play the game, various hints, you know, important stuff that you might need to know. Like, you can get a map from this lady. I'm not gonna bother since, well, it's just gonna take up an inventory spot. That's about the only important guy in this place. I think the only other one that I would consider somewhat important, is that guy who obviously has to go to the bathroom extremely badly. is this guy. Yeah, magic butterfly. Pretty much what it does is calm you down, and the effects, game-wise, is the gaining of 20 PP, which is, you know, at this point of the game, that's pretty awesome. But I need to pee. Please? But fine. You know, this is the trouble with it. Everywhere you go, you know, that being a blatant, you know, poking fun at all RPGs that don't have bathrooms, which is the vast majority of them. Ah, hello. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. Oh! Come here. Wow. You are just so full of information, sir. I guess Eagle Land's supposed to be a alternate reality Earth. Well, I wonder what kind of activities they're engaging in. I don't think Ness is old enough for this conversation. Not anymore, at least. Boom. But milk does a body good. I'm going to be so obnoxious in this playthrough. Holy crap, I can actually get into this one. And there's nobody home. Yeah. There's no beds. They just sleep on the couch. There's no stove. There's no bathroom. The hospital, not really important at this part of the game. Oh, that's nice. Right. You know what's always bugged me about... I'm sure I've said this before. The thing that has always bugged me about... anyone who is in the medical field, it's like, oh, I've been practicing for X amount of years. You still don't have it right? I don't know. Maybe I'm nitpicking. Yeah, I've already outgrown the enemies in the beginning of the- Oh, womp womp. The only reason I don't instant win those guys is they're a little bit faster than I didn't talk to Liar Exaggerate, did I? Crap! I have to do that. Indeed. You know, at this point in the game, 7,500 bucks is way too much. But later in the game, you might as well just, you know, buy it. You know, just for giggles. I mean, later... Come here. Later in the game, 7,500, you'll get that from fighting, like, two enemies. Especially if they happen to be a special enemy. Yeah, there's literally no reason that I'm fighting those guys. If I was faster than them, the game would probably... No, I'm assuming it's a speed thing. I have no idea. I have no idea how the... I've always assumed that it has to deal with your offense and speed. Like, if you go before them, and you'll kill them one hit, insta-wins. But I'm not sure. Wow, you're useful. You lied. Hey, Grandma. How you doing? The best medicine for an unconscious character is not to let them go unconscious. I'm sure you don't need to be told that. But you know how in most games you have to go to an armor store or whatever to buy wonderful things for your characters? A lot of this is like department stores and drug stores and whatnot, yeah. Being possessed by this... Ugh. No. Actually, no, I don't. It's not there. See, this one little detail just makes it so much easier to pick out your items. The only thing that really doesn't apply to is some items don't really give you stats. They give you immunities. So, it's good for, regular weapons, regular armor, you know, not, like, absurd, so right now you don't have to worry about it. Does he repeat that, or? No, he just repeats it, and blah, 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 blah. I thought you were supposed to become a regular dog. Apparently not, no. Thank you. Oh, by the way, this is a green phone. It's a payphone. It costs $1 to use. I tried to avoid those, but you should call your mom. I left home 20 minutes ago. Sheesh, I don't think she's worried about me yet. But he's actually hinting on a mechanic. Yeah, as that wonderful dog over there mentioned, blinking. Since I picked up that free hat, Mr. Baseball Cap, Mr. Whatever it was called, I don't need that, so that saves me 19 bucks. I need to press the right button. That would help a lot. Yes, please. 5 defense for... It is really expensive. Oh, yeah, I actually have exactly enough for that. The yo-yo might be tempting, but... The thing is hits your hit percentage in this game is fraction based, like everything. I think normal weapons have like 1/16th of a chance to miss. The thing is with yo-yos, it's like 1/4 or something. It's a significant miss chance. Everyone can equip them, but they're not very good. And despite what your mother tells you, if you're in Eagle Land, playing in the street will not get you murdered. Hey. It's, nice weather we got here. How's that, van treating you? It's good? Alright. And he goes, like, 10 more feet and stops. You can't get run over in this game, although, same truck again. Being that blatantly dark really isn't the game style. Yeah. Just completely obliterate the... They're hinting that there's a tutorial in the library, is the thing. Let's go find the liar exaggerate. At least, it is really important that I do talk to him due to, you know, story bits. If I don't talk to him, that later you're gonna be like, if you've never played the game. I'm glad I didn't forget, because otherwise, you know, problems and stuff. Oh, the whole green swirl thing, since I'm on it with the spiteful crow, I was on it earlier. You know, the reason I think it comes down to speed a lot is because the spiteful crow has really high speed, but they're one of the enemies in the beginning. I don't know, maybe they actually have a level. I don't know. I haven't really engage myself in the game that much, but the thing is that I just smashed him and he died. I don't get it. The Spiteful Crow, actually, a lot later, you'll be much higher level and you will still have to go into battle with them. Which is weird. Although he does have a nice bow tie. You know, I've come to the conclusion why everyone is fat in this universe. Every bird you murder gives you a cookie. I mean, seriously, how would anyone stay skinny in a world where cookies just come everywhere from every which direction? I mean, what kind of cookies are they? Are they good cookies? You know, they're probably like Oreo double stuffs. That's what they are. They're not like chocolate chip, I see you. They're chocolate chips with mint. I don't know. RVG, why are you contemplating so much about food in a game? But the thing is, you know, a lot of other games, you know, they got the potion. You know, I always imagine, you know, like Diablo-style potions. That's what's always in my head. Like, even before Diablo came out, that's what I saw. And his bed is horrible. But, you know, with a game like this that has realistic food items, it's like, you know, what kind of cookie do you imagine? What kind of bread roll do you imagine? What kind of hamburger do you imagine? Possibly, preferably not, you know, fast food hamburgers. Anyway. Yeah, I'm gonna keep all my thoughts to myself about this scene. The whole, you know, guy. Yeah, let's stop talking. Creepy. This music's not helping my cause either of not being creeped out. At all. So, why are you showing me? Oh. Wonder what that's all about. Just strange glowing, and yeah, this whole scene. You don't have to do this at all. I mean, it's not gonna change the story any. It's a Super Nintendo game. Also, the wheelbarrows in this game just look really, really just wrong. I don't know, maybe that's just me. But, you know, if I don't do it, those of you who possibly haven't played this game might be confused as to some later events. You know, just making sure I cover all my bases to all the things. I did say that earlier that I was going to play, like, you know, going through for the first time, not knowing what I'm doing, and just flailing at things. Although, you know, that said, I'm not going to be dumb about it either. I love Onett's music. I really do. Just so bright and cheery. And, yeah, let me just show you a sign. This one right here. That should tell you everything about the beginning of the game. Yeah, I'm fine. Sure. Oh, I forgot about this mechanic in the game. Not only did this game come with, you know, if you bought it, like, in the big box, it came with the manual to tell you exactly what to do. You can go in the game, find this dude, and you can give him in-game money to get hints. I don't really remember using him ever. I mean, I don't even remember if there. You know, I don't remember using him, but I'm sure I must have at one point, just curiosity of what he might say. I don't know if the hints are any good. Anyway, what I was talking about is, you know, it came with a manual, and it comes with, you know, an in-game hint system. They wanted you to play this game to completion. Wanted policemen to close roads. Well, they are going for the record. Oh. Yeah, talking about the place where you can get the Hat of Happiness? No, no, no. Hey! I can't get around your lovely table. Hinting, yeah. Trying to make sure that you don't miss things. Yeah, remember when I said that sign pretty much explains everything? Beginning of the game? Yeah. Yeah. The whole... Hello, little girl. The less said about that, the better. Turn the lights on, maybe? I'm just meandering through town at this point. Cop station? Really no reason to go in there. The bakery? More food items. So, most of it's actually reasonably, creature from the vegetable soup? What about the creature from the vegetable soup? But I want to know that story. It's the thing you do in the bathroom. Yeah. I can't believe I just made that joke. She's hinting at the fact that in this game, not only do you have food items, you have condiments that can make the food item better or worse. You know, you're not gonna put hot sauce on a cookie, for example, unless you're really strange. Could you... Okay, having someone wander... That's back here, that's just silly. Skip sandwich, they make you run. Not really too exciting. Lucky sandwiches are just far too expensive. And bread rolls are pretty good. At this part of the game, once you get up to like 6... Oh, jeez, the sharks are out in force. Let's just avoid you. Yeah, I should probably wait one or two. No, I've never had the impulse to say checkaroni before. Ever, actually. Well, the thing is, I still need to go to Giant Step first. Yeah, the sharks. Maybe, can I get just one of them involved? It's obvious which ones are going to try to fight you right away. I mean, they jitter. There was also a magical butterfly. Ah, the skate punk. I'm pretty sure you guys call for help. Or are you guys the ones that hurt? Well, that was quick. 12 experience. It's 48 HP, and Yeah, Magic Butterfly, as far as finding them, is usually a crapshoot. Like, a huge crapshoot. There are a few places in the game where they always show up, and none of these houses have doors on them, oddly. No reason to visit the hospital. I don't think there's anybody really interesting in the hospital. For the most part, it's just, you know, strange lady. Mushroomized. Embarrassing itch, like, yeah, let's not go. Pretty much anything that you want done, you'll actually, as far as, you know, my play experience, you almost never talk to the actual doctor. You usually talk to the healer the most. Usually. Do. Hey! Yeah, peace and love. He's the leader of the gang, yet there's people all over the place trying to murder some boy with a yellow backpack. Hello, puppy. Congratulations. Hotel that I can pay money to stay if I really, really wanted to. I could always use my actual bed. Oh. Yes. That's EarthBound for you. that, as far as I'm concerned, that one guy. Don't break the wind of change. Fart jokes. Fresh breeze movement. This screen right here, this billboard, and that house pretty much sums up EarthBound. If you wanted it summed up, there you go. Oh boy. Anyway, next time, more EarthBound. And, well, for one, well, I need to introduce you to the sharks enemies, the cobbler that are over there. And I'd also like to get up to, 7? 8? 8 would probably be too far. Yeah, it doesn't really matter, but next time, more EarthBound. And more wandering around aimlessly. I told you I was going to do this. Although, silly times have been had, so I guess that's okay.